It's about 8:30 at night, and these things have been drying for a couple of days. So I decided to come out and start filling these with epoxy so they can start drying. Best red money can buy comes from the dollar store. All right, we're ready to go. Actually, I think I have better lighting in my shop for filming when it's completely dark out. But you can let me know what you think. Maybe I'll start shooting at night. I think you guys get the idea, right? This is the star section. I'm gonna sand this down. I'm basically gonna make this look like this.
See, that looks pretty good.
I decided just to go ahead and do epoxy inlay with pure white. So I've mixed up some epoxy, and I think I'm gonna break it down so I still have some red to do.
All right, let's put this in the oven and bake it at 375 for, I'd say about 15 minutes.
I want this Cal Fire flag to be like kind of in the middle, so I'm gonna pour a little bit of a base, set it in there, and pour the rest. Behind this board, I'm going to be adding an LED light strip. So I want to do some cutouts to let that light out a little bit. So I've already got it programmed. I've already got a piece set up, ready to cut. So we'll start with the sides, up and down, and the styles, I guess you'd say, of it, the whole project. and then we'll modify it to cut slots in these long pieces so that some of that light gets out. So what I typically do on my flags is I'll attach the sides and the bottom, and I'll work it up. And then at the end, I'll cut it flush because I make this a little taller than it needs to be. And then I'll add the very last strip.
Okay, what I typically like to do is drill and countersink. This framing. And then the stripes will hide the screws.
All right, so I gotta apologize. I have done a bit of work without filming. I just kinda got tired of filming everything I did for everything I do for a few days. So I am a little bit ahead. I have attached some of these stripes. Not a big deal. They're just glued down.
Initially, I asked my client if he wanted me to do the last white stripe, the last long one, the third white, and up in red, as firefighters like, or blue if you're a cop, or you know, so on and so forth. And he said, "Yeah, let's do that. I think that's appropriate." And then I was getting ready to do that, and then I had already told my client that I had planned to do a little backing of LEDs. So he got in touch with me and said, "Hey, are we able to make this part epoxy so that the LED shines through that?" And I said, "Well, I don't know. Let's try it." So I poured that yesterday. I cut this part out on the X-carve. Instead of just doing clear, let me move you over here. I decided to do like some flames and smoke, hoping that the LEDs will shine through that from behind. I don't know, I've never done it. Well, we're gonna see, but obviously this project has continued to evolve.
So I've also went over this axe, fireman's axe, hatchet, whatever you wanna call it, fireman's axe. Kind of with a fine-tooth comb. I wasn't happy with some of the craftsmanship on this. Really just the way this was cut and angled. It was really crooked and off and crappy. Having been a firefighter myself, spending days sharpening and fine-tuning our axes and equipment, I just wasn't quite happy with it for someone who gave a whole lifetime of service to the fire department. So I decided to fix it.
Throw a little bit of the white you see behind here is just the white of the melamine, so it's actually clear, but the smoke, I just want to maybe add some lighter highlights. All right, so we've got these stripes on. I went ahead off camera and just glued on the stars portion. And now it's just time to finish the stripes.
Yay!
So we'll glue these maybe one or two at a time. I don't know. We'll see.
too much glue.
Not too much. That's right. This thing's almost done. I have one more stripe to add, but first I've got to come up with a way to mount this axe on here, and I'm pretty sure that I've figured out exactly how I want to do it, but I'll be building all these mounting parts from scratch, so let's do that. The first thing that I gotta do, let's get rid of that for a second. So the first thing I gotta do is I gotta figure out where I'm gonna drill the holes, and basically I'm gonna be attaching this with like a series of dowels. And then on the dowel that actually holds it, I'm gonna put the rank in there. So that should be pretty cool. Now that I have my pilot holes drilled, it's time to set up for the dowels themselves. 3/4. 3/4 by 1¼ inches. So I'm gonna take these dowels over and I'm gonna go ahead and cut 2 of the 3/4, and I need 4 caps for each end. So I'll cut 4 of those. That should sit in there. So before I get this completely mounted in, it's time to go ahead and finish this back stripe, and then I want to get everything sanded and close to being finished. See, I should have done that before I put these on here. Very nice. So essentially what I'm doing here is take these larger pieces, stick them on that, and glue it. And that will hold it on there. Thank you. That's pretty cool, I think. And then I'll go through and I'll cap it on the other end and glue that. And that should hold it in. I'll add the rink in the end of that.
We're about ready to wrap this thing up. Off camera, I've already cleaned up all the edges with a flush cut bit in my router, and I have glued my dowels in for mounting this axe. I still have the finishing work to do, so I'm gonna sand this off camera. I'm gonna basically take it from probably about a 120 down to the 400, and then I'll, just like I do on my cutting boards, I'll buff out all of this epoxy. Supporting.
This one actually comes with some tacky side. Try to do is just center it by eye and try to get it to go in. That's pretty good. We are able to call this mission complete. A lot of stuff. Scratch all that. The epoxy for the stars has been setting overnight. It's actually already dry, which I'm pretty surprised because it's a little cold out. Either way, I've sanded all these three boards down, just 80 grit. All right, we're about ready to wrap this thing up. I've already cleaned up the edges with a flush bit on my router. Flush trim. I don't know. What the fuck am I talking about? A flush cut bit.
Hey, she looks like she's pooping a little bit. All right, thanks. I'll talk to you later. All right, bye.